Hello and welcome to the series of dynamic array functions in Excel. In this video, we will discuss the SORTBY formula in Excel. In the previous video, we explored the SORT formula in Excel, which allows you to sort data in a specified range or array. But what if you want to sort your data based on values in another range? That's where the SORTBY function comes in. This we will learn in detail through the following steps. First, what is the difference between the SORT and SORTBY formulas? Second, understand the SORTBY formula syntax. Lastly, sorting data by single column and multiple columns. So first, what is the difference between the SORT and SORTBY formulas? The main difference between SORT and SORTBY is that the SORT function sorts values based on the range selected. While the SORTBY function sorts based on another range or array, allowing more flexibility and customization. Sorting by multiple columns in the SORT function is complex, whereas the SORTBY simplifies the process by allowing multiple columns or ranges to be sorted in a single step. Now let's go to Excel to understand its syntax. In Excel, like SORT function, it can be found in the Formulas tab, in the Function library, under the Lookup and Reference group. To view the syntax, simply type equal to, sort by, open parenthesis, and you will see its syntax. The sort by function follows this syntax. It's quite straightforward. Let's take a look. It has two required arguments and the rest are optional arguments. You can see that the formula does not end here. The three dots in the syntax indicate that you can repeat the by underscore array and sort underscore order in the pairs as needed. This allows you to specify multiple sorting criteria. To understand it better, let's click on this function sign and it will open a dialog box, Function Arguments. Currently, it only displays two arguments, which are mandatory. The first argument is the array, which represents the array of data that we would like to sort. This is what we want to rearrange based on a specific set of criteria. We then have by underscore array 1, which refers to the array of values we want to sort our data by. This is our main criteria for sorting. Clicking within the second argument will bring up the third one, that is sort underscore order 1, and it's an optional argument. It can be used to specify the sort order, with a 1-4 ascending order and minus 1-4 descending order. By using these three arguments, we can sort the range by a single column. Now, clicking within the third argument will bring up the second sort criteria. Once you click within it, on the right side here, you will see the scroll bar. Here, each criteria have two arguments, 1-4 by array and 1-4 sort order. Scroll down and you can see the limit is 126. These criteria allow you to sort by multiple columns up to 126. There may be more than 126 allowed, but I haven't tested it. We will now take a look at a few examples, starting with sorting by a single column. Let's select the date column as an array. We will sort this by customer name, so select it. Then click OK. It's sorted by customer 1, followed by customer 2, and so on. By default, it sorts ascending, so even if you don't write 1, it will still work. However, if you wish to sort by descending order, simply write minus 1, accept the changes. And it will sort the range in descending. Now, let's understand sorting by multiple columns. In the example we have, there are multiple line items for each customer. Like, customer 1, for instance, has 5 line items. In this case, we can add another sorting criterion, such as product, to further refine the sort. Let's update the formula accordingly. To maintain ascending order for both sorting criteria, remove the minus one that we used previously. And we can skip it by adding two commas like this, and it will be sorted in ascending. For the second criteria, select the range representing the product column. It is important to remember that, when you add the second, or any subsequent sorting criteria, both arguments inside the square brackets must be defined. Otherwise, it will result in an error. As an example, without defining the sort order here, if we click OK, it gives an error. So, even if you want to sort in ascending order for all criteria, make sure to use a comma after the first sorting array and before the second sorting array, like this. So, let's add comma here and click OK. Now, we can see that the dates column is sorted first by customer and then by product. It is important to note that when using the sort by function in Excel, you have the flexibility to select sorting criteria outside the range or within the range. The outside range is not the only limitation for selecting the sort criteria. In fact, you can include the sort criteria column within the range itself. In this example, if we expand the array to include both the customer and product columns, the sorting criteria we selected will be applied to the entire range. By accepting the changes, the data will be sorted according to the specified criteria. This demonstrates how the sort by works. It provides enhanced functionality and flexibility compared to the sort function, catering to different sorting needs. Ultimately, the choice between sort and sort by depends on your specific requirements and the complexity of your sorting criteria.